Starting off with an older coin. Now this one's really cool. It's an Indian head penny. So it's from 1906. Now this Indian head 1 cent coin was actually struck on a 10 cent planchet. So here is one of the 15 unbelievable coins that we're gonna be looking at, because this Indian head 1 cent coin sold for over $19,000. That's right, 19,000 US dollars. So these Indian head pennies, of course, they're not supposed to have this silver color to them. So definitely always be on the lookout for those. Now, if we move on to another 1906 Indian head penny. Now, this one is very cool because it is an error coin as well. It has been triple struck, and we can really see that there in the images displayed as we zoom around the coin there. Now, here on the reverse, we can see that taking place as well. If you look there at the shield, the reef, all that, you could really see that error taking place. Now, because of that, this 1 cent coin sold for over $700. Now, keep in mind, if this coin had a higher grade, if it was in much better condition, it would have sold for probably thousands of dollars. However, this one's got a lower grade, so it's not gonna sell for as much. It's really value is all in the error itself. So moving on to a 1918S. Now this is a Walking Liberty half dollar, 90% silver half dollar, one of my favorite US coin designs that they have ever made. Now it has been broad struck, and because of that error, this coin sold for over $5,000, which we see that error taking place on the coin there. Now, next up is a really, really cool coin. This is a Buffalo nickel that is super valuable. It is from 1936. Now, if you want to call it an Indian head nickel, Buffalo nickel, however you want to classify it. This 5 cent coin has actually been double struck, which we can see here. If we zoom in here to the top, you can actually see the words E Pluribus Unum that will be on the reverse of the coin. So this one is very, very noticeable here, the errors on this 1936 Buffalo nickel. Now we can see that here on the reverse of the coin taking place as well. Now this coin here sold for over $4,000, 4,000 US dollars. Next up is a very cool coin. This is supposed to be a 1941 wheat penny. However, it was struck on a Panama 1 cent planchet. So you see how it's got that goldish color tone to it? Well, that is because if we look at this Panama 1 cent coin, from the 1940s. This is the planchet that the 1 cent coin was actually struck on. Now you can see that the coin has definitely been circulated, not a lot, but you can tell it's got some nicks in it and stuff. It's definitely probably been found by somebody in change or in a coin roll or something of that nature. But it is in very, very, very good condition as well. Now this coin here sold for over $3,700 because of that mint error. Next up is another wheat penny. Now this one is a 1958 wheat penny that was overstruck on a 1958 Cuba 1 cent coin. So we got a double denomination taking place here, similar to the last coin, but you can actually see the design of the Cuban coin on his shoulder, on his chest. And then over here to the right side, even almost to the date 1958, you can see that lettering from the Cuban coin. So very, very cool. We also see that the whole design of the coin is being cut off there, especially there at the top and on the left side here on the reverse. Now, this coin here sold for over $3,000. So always be on the lookout for strange things like these, because you never know what you can find in a coin roll. You just never know. Moving on to a 1964 Lincoln penny. Now this has been overstruck on a 1963 Denver minted Lincoln penny, which is very cool. So we can see here clearly in the image displayed. Now a lot of fakes of these are out there. There's a lot of vice jobs. People send me those pictures all the time. You can tell when they are fake. This is actually a legitimate one. I absolutely love this. I would go insane if I found this in a coin roll. I mean, I would seriously go insane. I really need to go to the bank and get some more pennies and hunt for these coins. This is just an amazing, amazing error. Now, this penny here sold for over $4,000. That's right, $4,000. We can actually see the 1963 here on the reverse of the Lincoln penny. So very cool there. That is, I mean, wow. Could you imagine finding that? That would be incredible. All right, next up is just a regular 1965 quarter, right? That's what it looks like, 1965 quarter, nothing special. However, this quarter was actually struck on a 90% silver planchet. So if you guys are new to coin collecting, they stopped making the 90% quarters in 1964. 1965, they started the clad quarters, which did not have silver. So this quarter here is not supposed to be silver. However, it actually was struck on a silver planchet. So that will give the coin a lot of value. Now, this quarter sold for over $5,000. And if you want to know how to tell if your quarter is silver or not, well, one way is to weigh it. So a typical silver quarter will weigh around 6.25 grams, and a non-silver quarter will weigh around 5.67 grams. So just keep that in mind when you're weighing them. I have coin scales available on couchcollectibles.com if that's for you. And also, all you gotta do is look at the edge of the quarter. I mean, really, if you're familiar with silver coins, you will see one, you would know it's silver. However, if you're new to this, then go check out my silver coins videos. I go more into depth of what coins are actually supposed to be silver and how to tell if your coins are silver. All right, now same thing with this next coin. This is a Kennedy half dollar from 1977, and it is super valuable. The coin sold for over $6,000 because it was struck on a 40% silver planchet. Again, I can personally tell by looking at the coin that it's silver, but if you are new to it and you cannot, a silver 40% silver half dollar is going to weigh around 11.5 grams. Now, a 90% silver Kennedy half dollar is going to weigh around 12.5 grams. However, this 1977 is not supposed to be silver at all, so this coin is supposed to be non-silver, which the non-silver half dollars weigh around 11.34 grams. So if you find one and it weighs over, you know, 11.5 or around 11.5, get it, inspect it, check it out. And yeah, hopefully you can find one. That would be amazing. Like I said, this coin sold for over $6,000. All right, here we go. 1983 copper penny. Now, this one has been struck on a copper planchet. Now, before you say I have a 1983 penny and I want to sell it in the comments below, all you have to do is go type in 1982 and 1983 penny, and then just put 1982 penny couch collectibles, 1983 penny couch collectibles, and you will find my videos where I explain everything about those pennies and what to look for and the weights and all that stuff. So go check it out. This penny is not supposed to be on that copper planchet. It's supposed to be on the zinc planchet. Now, this coin sold for over $16,000. A $16,000 penny. Moving on to a really cool coin. Now, this is a 1991 to 1995 half dollar coin. That is the World War II version, and it's been double struck with both strikes being off center there. So very clear and noticeable error. But I thought this was an interesting coin to throw in the video. This half dollar sold for over $10,000. That's right, 10 grand. All right, next up is a coin that I've shown in previous videos. Now, this is a 2000 penny that was struck on a 2000 quarter. So very, very cool. It's a double denomination. Pretty self-explanatory. Very, very awesome error coin taking place here, and a super valuable coin. This coin here sold for over $15,000. Now, if we move on to a no-dated Indian head penny, we see that it's got the reverse die cap here on this 1 cent coin. No front design here, and this 1 cent coin sold for over $7,000. Moving on to a very cool coin. Now, here's what a Morgan dollar will typically look like, and then here's what this Morgan dollar looks like. So we can obviously see that error taking place on this coin. It's been struck 20% off center, and it's got a brokerage on the reverse. Now, it's not in the best condition, but it is a super awesome error. And this Morgan dollar coin sold for over $12,000. Next up is a very cool coin. Now this was actually struck on a foreign planchet from Ghana. So here's what the Ghana coin actually looks like. And then this is a Sacagawea dollar design that was actually struck on that Ghana coin planchet. So very, very awesome. This coin, or whatever you would like to call it, sold for over $3,700. Alright guys, don't forget to subscribe in the middle, check out the videos to the left of me, and until tomorrow, I will see you on the comment section below. This is Couch Collectibles, and this is where I disappear.